So you want to go to Hawaii and you want to visit for as cheap as possible and stay in the highest level of luxury you can. Well, today we're going to help you do just that. Now, who am I to tell you how to visit Hawaii at a good price? So I'm Sean. I'm the guy that literally wrote the college level course on credit card rewards. I've been to Hawaii 11 times. In a few days, I'm going to go for my 12th time. So I really hope I'm going to be able to help you out here. Let's not waste any of your time. So let's get started with the very beginning here. So before we talk about how to go to Hawaii, the flights and the hotels and all that, let's talk about the islands. So Hawaii has four major islands that actually like have hotels and that you can go visit. So one is Kauai. Kauai is a very like not as developed island. It's not as popular as like Maui or Oahu or the bigger islands. There's a lot of beautiful, beautiful parts to Kauai, but we're not going to find as many like hotels to redeem at or as many options there. Maui's a very touristy island. It's like one of the most popular islands that people go to. It's very luxury. It's probably the most luxurious island that we'll find in Hawaii, the highest concentration of super high-end hotels. And it's also a very fairly large island, so there is kind of a lot to do. The most populated and most city-like island is going to be Oahu. So Oahu, especially the picture you see here, this is of Waikiki Beach. A lot of people call this like Las Vegas on the beach. It's basically a huge bustling city, downtown, skyscrapers, all that. Still a very, very beautiful beach, but it's not going to be like kind of serene and tranquil like you might typically imagine Hawaii being. It's going to be more like crowded, bustling city. I actually personally really like it, but you'll have to kind of figure out what you like. And then of course there's the big island of Hawaii. This is the only island or the only major island of Hawaii that I haven't yet been to. So the big island, as you might expect, is the biggest island. And there's a lot to do, but it is a newer island, relatively speaking, in terms of like millions of years. So a lot of the beaches on the big island are going to be like lava rock. It's not going to be as many like sand beaches and stuff. And so there's a lot of different variety between these islands, and I'd recommend doing more research into each of them. But kind of as a quick thing here, Kauai is going to be the smallest island, the greenest island of them all because there's so much rain and so much lush forest. Maui's going to be our kind of highest end island in the sense that there's the highest concentration of luxury hotels. Oahu is going to be like if you want the full city experience, you want like Vegas on the beach. And the big island is going to be just if you want like this huge, massive Hawaiian island with probably the biggest variety of things to do. So the four main islands. Now we're going to be talking about like flight redemption options and hotel redemption options for each of them. And so, yeah, let's move on here. So flights. Okay. Option one, if you have Chase points, you can redeem them at 1.5 cents on the, I'm just kidding, guys. This is an amateur hour. Okay. I'm not going to screw with you on stupid redemptions like the Chase portal. This is big boy hour. We're going to talk about legit ways to actually get to Hawaii. So you need to fly to Hawaii. Flights to Hawaii are fairly expensive. You know, they're not cheap things to do, especially if you're on the East Coast. Even on the West Coast, they can be fairly expensive at like $500 round trip. So the big boy play, if we want to fly to Hawaii, is going to be Turkish miles flying United Airlines. This is like the cream de la cream of airline redemptions, okay? The pricing on this is only 7.5K. One way in Y stands for economy. So redeeming Turkish miles in one way economy on United Airlines only costs 7,500 miles. That is insanely cheap. Even better, 12,500 miles one way in business. That is an awesome, awesome, awesome redemption. Good luck finding availability though. It's really tough to find availability for this in business. In economy though, it's pretty easy. And this is so powerful because this works for virtually any domestic routing in the United States on United Airlines, assuming there is saver ticket availability. So you could fly from Newark to Honolulu for only 7,500 miles one way in economy. Now, it doesn't have to be a direct flight. You could do a stopover, a layover, I mean. As long as the layover is under 4 hours, it's still only 7,500 miles one way. And so we're looking for something like this, right? So this is a screenshot I grabbed from like Denver to Honolulu, and it's only 7,500 miles one way, directly bookable on the Turkish Airlines website for only 7,500 miles one way. It is such a good redemption. It is the best way to get to Hawaii in terms of price-wise, because you're flying a full-service carrier, which is United, right? It's not the best airline, but whatever. And it's only 7,500 miles. It's so cheap. There's so many different options. It doesn't have to be a direct flight. This is the way to go to Hawaii. The best way to go, screw the Chase portal, screw any of these fixed cents per points. Oh, Delta, I'm going to spend 80 million sky pesos on my 3-stopover leg to Hawaii. No, this is the big boy play, Turkish miles on United. Now, okay, so we said what you're looking for, but here's the thing, okay? So we have, there's two options to earn Turkish miles, okay? So let's first talk about how we get these miles. It's only 7,500. How do we actually earn them? So the two main options are going to be Capital One and City, okay? Capital One and City are going to be my picks. Built, I guess, too. But who's got a big stash of built points? I don't. So you could use built points as well for this. I personally think Capital One's probably the best one to use for this because the miles are pretty easy to earn and they don't have that many other amazing options. City has some other good options that I might want to save for. Capital One, this is probably their best option. So I'd really recommend earning it with Capital One. And remember, the miles transfer one-to-one from Capital One over to Turkish Airlines. So if you get the Venture X card, the sign-up offer on that is usually 75,000 points. That's enough for 5 round-trip tickets to Hawaii. You could be on Newark on the other side of the entire, like, you know, country and fly 10 hours plus to Hawaii for 15,000 miles round-trip. So one sign-up bonus is 5 round-trip tickets. That is absurdly good. By the way, if you end up applying for the VentureX and you want to support the channel, please check out the affiliate links in the description. It helps out so much. The other option, of course, would be something like the City Premier. So the bonus on that hovers around 60 to 80,000 points. Still, again, transfers one-to-one over to Turkish. Very, very respectable amount of points. And you're still getting, you know, 4 to 5 plus round-trip tickets to Hawaii, anywhere in the United States that United serves, assuming there is saver level availability. And this is critical. So how do we search for this saver level availability? The easiest way to do it is going to be on United Airlines. So United Airlines has a calendar search function where you can just search your routing and you can search for miles and it will show the whole month at once. And it's very, very easy to parse. Okay. And so what we're specifically looking for here is this saver award. Okay. See how it says saver award. That is very, very important because if it doesn't say saver award, we can't book it with this amazing deal. Okay. You can't book it with Turkish. It's only saver level awards. So we've seen a saver award. Now we see it's available August 17th, LAX to Honolulu saver. We've confirmed it. We know it's available. So let's head on to Turkish to now book it. Okay. So we head on to Turkish. Uh-oh. What's this? I searched the exact same routing. We confirmed there was availability. We know there's saver level availability. I'm looking for one passenger. It's first of all, it's not even showing me the flight from LAX to Honolulu for whatever reason, which is stupid because I don't want a layover. Who wants to do a layover, right? It's showing me only flights that have a layover in SFO, and it's also saying no seats are available. But we just confirmed the seats are available. So what is this? Okay. Oh no. This is a fate worse than death. We have to deal with Turkish Airlines customer service. Okay. Now I've got a POV of what Turkish Airlines customer service looks like when they're going into work. POV Turkish Airlines reps showing up to give me the worst customer service experience of my entire life. So if you're not aware, dealing with Turkish Airlines customer service is not fun. So you can still book these seats. We confirmed their saver level availability. They should be able to still book them on Turkish directly, but you'll have to call them up or email them to get these seats. And you may have to do it several times because the reps might not know what they're talking about. And even though there is availability that they can book, for some reason they say they can't see it, but they definitely can. You just have to like call in and convince them. And if they still can't, hang up, call a different rep. Okay. But luckily for you, I have a guide to deal with Turkish Airline customer service. Okay. This is the comprehensive guide that you will need. Okay. You ready? Boom. The phonetic alphabet. Okay. If you've ever dealt with Turkish Airlines customer service, you will know that they basically need you to phonetically read off everything. So like you cannot give them like your email address spelling out the letters. You'll have to be like A as in alpha, H as in hotel, that type of thing. So have the phonetic alphabet pulled up if you're calling Turkish Airlines customer service. It will help you so much and it will make it so much easier to deal with them. It's not that the representatives aren't nice. They were actually very friendly. It's just they're not that good. Their microphones suck, so it's really tough to understand them. It's like they're very quiet and the microphone's very bad. It's tough to understand them. And a lot of times they'll not like, you'll try to explain something, but they won't fully understand what you mean. And so you may have to call reps a couple times. You'll have to be very, very clear in what you're trying to do. But if the saver availability is there, it should definitely be doable. So just keep that in mind. If the availability is on United, but it's not showing up on Turkish, you will have to call them up. If it's on Turkish's website, though, that's awesome. Just book via the Turkish website. So much easier. But this is still the very, very best way to fly to Hawaii. Like, there's bar none. There's almost no exception that this is the cheapest and best way to get to Hawaii. Okay, assuming you can deal with Turkish Airlines. So let's move on to the hotel redemption side of things. So let's first talk about Big Island hotels. Now, I haven't been to the Big Island myself, So take these recommendations with a grain of salt. These are just a couple of fairly optimal redemptions I've pulled up. So one that I've been eyeballing for a fairly long time is the Hilton Waialoka Village. Now, this one's only 75,000 Hilton points a night, which is fairly reasonable because remember that with Hilton points, we get the fifth night free, assuming you have any level of Hilton status. So it's actually not like that expensive. And so even though the cash rates on this aren't that high, depending on when you're going, it actually is a fairly reasonable redemption. It's not top tier, but it's a good enough redemption. And so it's something I would consider. And keep in mind, you can buy Hilton points at half a cent a piece on sale. So you're not paying that much after fifth night free, even if you just want to buy the points directly. Another redemption, this is a bit higher end. This is an autograph hotel collection by Marriott, so the Mauna Kea. And so it's 75,000 to 100,000 Marriott points per night, not counting for fifth night free, because remember, we have the same kind of fifth night free benefit with Marriott. And so, you know, depending on when you're going, this is actually a fairly good redemption value. You're looking at about like 1 cent a point for Marriott points. It's a very expensive hotel in cash. Again, I've never stayed here, so I cannot personally recommend either of these hotels, but these do seem to be fairly decent redemption values. And unfortunately, you know, there's no Hyatts on the Big Island of Hawaii, so we can't get our phenomenal Hyatt redemption value there. But these are two ones I would look out for if you wanted to go to the Big Island. So now for Kauai, Kauai is very interesting on the hotel side. So my personal favorite redemption in Kauai, hotel-wise, and this is arguably the best hotel points redemption in all of Hawaii, would be the Grand Hyatt. The Grand Hyatt is a wonderful hotel. I've stayed there twice myself. Absolutely phenomenal hotel. Best pool complex of any hotel I've ever been to. Phenomenally maintained pools, giant saltwater lagoon pools, sand-bottomed, wonderful hotel. Absolutely breathtaking. Very good club lounge if you're globalist. Good service. 70% or something of the rooms face ocean view. So if you have any like high-level Hyatt status, decent chance of getting an ocean view upgrade. Wonderful hotel, 30,000 points. Hotel cash-wise goes for like $1,000 a night. Absolutely recommend it. If you buy the points, you could stay here for about $540 a night on sale. If you're thinking of buying points to stay in Hawaii, though, I'm going to tell you to hold off. I personally would not recommend buying points for the hotels, and we'll see why. But if you have Hyatt points and you want to stay here, phenomenal, phenomenal, phenomenal redemption. Absolutely recommend it. The other one, which is a much lower tier redemption, if you have Marriott points, is the Sheraton Kauai. So it's 65,000 to 75,000 Marriott points a night before fifth night free. I think it's a pretty good redemption. I've stayed at this hotel actually too, not on points back when I was younger. It's a nice hotel. It's good. It has a better beach in front of it than the Grand Hyatt, but the Grand Hyatt is just such a cool, big, massive resort with an amazing pool complex. And the Sheraton Kauai is just not nearly on that level, but it is a fairly decent value for Marriott points. So keep that in mind. Grand Hyatt all the way is my opinion on this for hotel value. Just keep in mind the beach isn't really swimmable out front. Now there's other options on Kauai. There's going to be another amazing option on Kauai we're going to look at near the end of this and this will be true for all the major islands on Hawaii, okay? So let's look at Maui hotels now. So Maui I've also went to in September. So one of my favorite redemptions on Maui, and it's still a very good redemption, is Hana Maui. So Hana Maui is a Category 7 Hyatt, 30,000 World of Hyatt points per night, about $600 to $800 a night cash value. And what's very interesting about this hotel is it's not a super like opulent hotel, despite being very expensive. It's more rustic and stuff, but it's the only hotel, or at least the only real hotel in Hana Maui. So Hana Maui is on the very, very east of Maui. You have to take the road to Hana to get to it. It's a very long drive. It's like, 2 hours minimum if you're not even stopping and you're supposed to stop along all the beautiful stops along the way. So it's like a 4, 5, 6 hour drive. And so a lot of people just go to Hana and come back the same day. That's exhausting, man. Like, who wants this? So stupid. Like, you're going to be exhausted all day. Spend a night or two in Hana. Great Hyatt points value. Amazing restaurant. Oh my God. The restaurant there is so good. The Hana Ranch restaurant. We had like one of the best dinners we've ever had there. It wasn't that expensive. Very friendly staff. Good globalist recognition. My only complaint is they got rid of their goddamn hot tub. That pissed me off. They had a hot tub and they like covered it up and they just got rid of it. Like, why would you? I get it's Hawaii. It's hot and stuff, but like, why would you do that, man? But wonderful hotel. Absolutely recommend staying there. Great value and Hyatt points. The other one, the other like top tier, and there's other places you can redeem points at too, but this is what I'd really recommend. The Grand Wailea is a phenomenal points redemption. So this is a Hilton property, 110,000 Hilton points a night. As of recording, very good availability here. And again, this is before fifth night free. So you can actually do fifth night free and buy the points and you stay here for well under half the cash, typical cash rate. I did not stay at the Grand Wailea, but I did get dinner there one night. Very beautiful hotel. It's massive. It's a huge sprawling resort. It's not really like Waldorf Astoria tier, despite being a Waldorf Astoria property. I think it's a wonderful hotel, phenomenal points redemption. I do want to stay here using Hilton certificate nights or Hilton points. I would recommend it. Friendly staff, good atmosphere, and it's a very good redemption value is really what we're going out here. 110,000 Hilton for this place is actually pretty reasonable if you're doing fifth night free or if you're doing Hilton certificates. So I would definitely recommend the Grand Wailea. And it's also a completely different area of Maui. While Hana's like super remote, you'd maximum spend like one or two nights there. Grand Wailea is in a huge like resort area, a really, really high end area of Maui. And you have a bunch of resorts nearby. You have the Andaz, which I stayed at. Absolutely love the Andaz. You have the Four Seasons nearby. You have some other ones like the Fairmont and stuff. So you're in a really high end area and you can spend a long time in Wailea. You could spend, you know, like weeks in Wailea for, you know, you're not going to get bored. So let's look at Oahu hotels now. Oahu hotels are a bit trickier here because there's not as many good points redemption values. I think the best points redemption value in Oahu is going to be the Royal Hawaiian Hotel. So in Oahu, the main beach where we saw that picture in the beginning of like all those towering skyscrapers right on the beach, that is Waikiki Beach. That's like the main beach of Oahu. And the best hotel on that entire beach, like that's on the water, is the Royal Hawaiian without question. So I've stayed here like, God, I've stayed here like 11 times. I think, no, 10 times. I've stayed here 10 times at this hotel, not on points, back when I was a kid, a lot more. But I did stay here about a year ago on points. It's not like it's classified as a luxury hotel. It's part of Marriott's luxury collection. I would not call it a true five-star hotel, but it is the best hotel on Waikiki Beach. And the points here, if you're redeeming for an increment of 5 nights using Marriott points, you can expect to get close to 1 cent per point. Fairly decent value for Marriott points. Right on the beach. It's a very historic hotel. It's all pink. It's, you know, like built in like 1913 or something. Super old hotel, but has a ton of character to it. My only major complaint is they absolutely give a horrible Marriott Platinum Elite breakfast. Completely joke of a breakfast. Like not even continental breakfast. The Holiday Inn next door probably has a better breakfast, but great. Overall, a good hotel. I would recommend staying here. The Ritz-Carlton Waikiki Residences is going to be a higher end hotel for sure, but you're going to get a worse redemption value and you're not on the beach. So that does kind of hurt the value significantly for me. If you're looking for a budget option, there is a Hyatt Place Waikiki, which is a decent value on points. It's about 240 bucks a night cash, 12,000 Hyatt points a night, standard night. I've never stayed here. It's a decent redemption value. You're not on the beach though. But it is decent redemption value. The Hyatt Regency Waikiki is going to be a lot nicer, but the redemption value just isn't there. Other hotels in Oahu probably just pay cash. There's some other decent Marriott hotels. Marriott has so many hotels in that whole strip on Waikiki. Like 3 hotels. They have the Moana Surfrider, the Royal Hawaiian, the Sheraton, the Marriott Waikiki Beach Resort. They're all right there. It's like Marriott dominated. So your points will actually be pretty useful there. But yeah, Royal Hawaiian would be my pick. If you're paying cash, Regency Waikiki is a pretty decent pick as well. Now, there's a superpower though, okay? There's a superpower to all these islands. Okay, so if you want to, let's say you don't have points. Let's say you don't have enough points or you got a bigger group going or you want to stay longer and you just don't have enough points yet. The superpower for all the Hawaiian islands, okay, for every single island that we just talked about, Vacasa is going to be your absolute best friend. So I've talked about Vacasa over and over and over again, but I need to tell you about it again because it's just so good. So overpowered, okay? You can book a Vacasa vacation rental for 15,000 Wyndham points per night per bedroom, okay? This includes all taxes and fees. I mean, maybe there's a few properties that kind of sneak around this, but basically for all the properties, it's all the taxes and fees, except parking. Parking, sometimes you'll have to pay a charge. Absolutely phenomenally overpowered, okay? Because you have options on all the major Hawaiian islands, okay? You have options on the Big Island, Maui, Kauai, and Oahu. Oahu has the worst of the options, but still, if you're looking far in advance, there's a couple good ones in there. I'm going to Oahu in like less than a week, and I'm gonna be staying for 14 nights, all in Vacasas. It's 2 different Vacasas. I'm staying in Waikiki Beach the whole time, okay? It's such a great value. And the way you do this is you buy the Wyndham points on sale. Okay, you don't need to earn the Wyndham points. Who's staying at Wyndham's? I'm not. You just buy Wyndham points. If you don't have any credit cards and you don't have anything else, you just make a Wyndham account and you buy the points on a good sale, you're only paying about $150 to $155 per night per bedroom. That is insane. I challenge you to find a crappy motel for $150 a night in Waikiki, okay? This is a phenomenal value to stay in a nice, comfortable, one-bedroom vacation rental in Waikiki Beach or just in anywhere in Hawaii for $150 a night per bedroom is insane. Because there's a ton of one-bedroom properties. There's a ton of two-bedroom properties and three-bedroom properties, okay? This is going to be your best value if you want to pay cash. There's not even a question, okay? Unless you want to stay something like the Grand Hyatt and you want that luxury hotel experience, the best value you're going to get in all of Hawaii is in Vacasa. Okay, and if you have the business earner card, if you have the Wyndham business earner credit card, it's only $125 per night per bedroom because you get a 10% rebate on your awards. That makes it even better, okay? You should absolutely be getting the Wyndham business card. It's such a phenomenal card. I absolutely love it. I don't even have a referral link to that card. I wish I did because I recommend it to everyone, but it's such a good credit card. I highly, highly, highly recommend it, okay? Vacasa's are going to be your best friend. This is a picture of a Vacasa, an actual Vacasa vacation rental in Hawaii on Kauai, actually. This is one I've been eyeballing myself. It's a two-bedroom unit, meaning I could book it with the business card for $250 a night, all in. I don't know how much you can see that picture. It's a super modern Vacasa. It's like beautiful looking, okay? It's in Princeville on the north part of Kauai. Absolutely phenomenal looking place, okay? And there's so many options. So let me just show you two examples here, okay? This is the one on the left here. That's the place I just showed you in that other picture. Super modern, super beautiful looking vacation rental. Like, it's so good. Like, the average rate before taxes is $550 a night. And this is bookable using your Wyndham points, two-bedroom, $250, $250 a night, only, like, 30,000 points a night if you don't even have the business card, 27,000 a night if you do have the business card. Super modern, you've got, like, these kind of, like, rock walls right in Princeville. You have, like, an ocean view. You go right out into your lawn. Beautiful place, okay? Absolutely amazing place in Kauai. Another one that I've been eyeballing, this is in Kona on the Big Island. This is a three-bedroom unit on the water with a sauna in the master bedroom, okay? Bookable, again, only 45,000 Wyndham points per night, even without the business card. It's such, I think Frequent Miler actually stayed in this very Vacasa vacation rental. I think, I may be wrong on that. Beautiful places, okay? If you're picking your places wisely and you're looking far out in advance, oh my God, you can get some phenomenal, phenomenal values. Just note that the cancellation policy is 30 days out or you lose all your points. And then also these properties usually have like a nightly minimum. So it's like three nights usually minimum. Some can have more, but three nights to four night minimum booking is what you're going to need to have. Also, what I just learned the other day, you can pool points across Wyndham accounts for the same stay. Now, the most you can pool is like per night. So for example, like each account would have to have enough to pay at least one night at the hotel. But let's say each account, you had three accounts that had like one night each. It does seem like you could just pool them all together and book a three night single reservation, pooling all the points. And they should be able to do that for you. I haven't done it myself, but according to the Frequent Miler article, it seems that it's possible you could do it. So just a amazing, amazing value. I cannot emphasize enough how good Vacasa is for Hawaii. Now let's move on. So we talked about the accommodations. We talked about the hotels. Those are going to be the main, or in the flights. Those are going to be the main things that we can optimize. Another cool thing, though, is your rental car. So if you're going to Hawaii, you probably need a rental car. Not as much in Oahu. Like, Oahu, you can definitely get away without a rental car because it's, like, such a densely populated city in Waikiki. But for any of the other islands, you're going to want a rental car. You're probably very much going to want a rental car. So the main way we're going to be able to optimize this is with status. Status is king here. There's not really a good way to do this on points. To be honest with you, you're going to have to shell up the cash, but I'd recommend trying to get Hertz President Circle status. So you can earn the status with the Venture X or the MX Platinum card. This is me. This wasn't actually using Hertz President Circle status. I had it, but I just ended up booking this car directly. We ended up booking a convertible for Maui. Awesome time. Recommend booking a convertible for Hawaii. It's really, really fun. But even if you don't want to pay that, if you book just a mid-sized car or above and your Hertz President Circle status is active, then you can go to the Hertz President Circle lot, depending, you know, which airport you're at, and just pick out any car in the Hertz President Circle lot. And you may find convertibles there, you may find SUVs there, higher tier cars than what you booked. So that is a really, really nice way to optimize it. And again, you get that status automatically if you hold the Venture X or the AMX Platinum card. Again, if you do apply for any credit cards and use the links in the description, it helps me out so much. I really appreciate it. Just make sure the cards make sense for you and the bonuses are good and all that. But recommend having Hertz President Circle status. It's a huge way to optimize your stay here and have a better rental car experience and not get stuck with some dumpy kind of, you know, cloth seat, tiny broken down sedan. Instead, you can get a big, nice SUV, minivan, convertible, those type of things. And so, yeah, I recommend for sure looking into Hertz President Circle status. Now, for activities in Hawaii, okay, We're not going to talk about the Big Island because I haven't been there yet, but I'll talk about like kind of one must-do activity for each of the islands. So for Kauai, I recommend going to Hanalei Bay. It's on the north part of Kauai. And, you know, it's not that far of a drive. It's like an hour drive each way. Kauai is a pretty small island, pretty easy to get to. Beautiful, beautiful bay. Calm, still water. It's much less populated than like the south part of Kauai. It's just absolutely beautiful. You know, of course, free to go to. Wonderful, wonderful place. I recommend visiting Hanalei Bay. For Maui, you definitely have to do Hana / the Black Sand Beach. So Hana again is on the east of Maui. You have to go through the Rota Hana, one of the most beautiful drives you'll ever do. And you got to visit Waianapanapa State Park. So this is in right near Hana. It's the famous Maui Black Sand Beach. And the sand is like really black. It's not like, oh, exaggerated for social media. It's like pitch black. Just note for the Black Sand Beach, you do need reservations in advance. So I almost forgot to do this. There was like one slot left on the day I was going to be there, and I booked it on the plane going there. So book this in advance if you want to do it. Definitely recommend doing the Black Sand Beach. Book it in advance. It does require reservations. And then for Oahu, again, also on the like the north part, there's Hanama Bay. It's a beautiful snorkeling part. It's not very expensive to get in. It's huge, tons of reefs, tons of marine life. Definitely recommend going to Hanama Bay on Oahu. You will need like a rental car or take like a bus up there or something. It's only open certain days of the week as well, so keep that in mind. 100% recommend it. Very, very good time in Oahu. So for food, just a couple food options you got to try. So in Kauai, you got to try Puka Dog. Love Puka Dog. They have veggie dog options. They have Polish sausage options. It's basically this big white fluffy bun with a hot dog in the middle. And they have like all these really, really tasty sauces. It's a bit expensive and it gets really crowded. But if you go when it's like not during like a lunch rush or something, I recommend it. It's really, really good. And then Waikomo Shave Ice is also a really good one. I love it because I have a very weird allergy. I have an allergy to like artificial coloring and food. So I love this place because the shave ice is completely natural there. So it's like all like no dyes, nothing artificial. Really, really soft ice too. Like a lot of these shave ice places have these like crunchy ass ice that's like, you know, like I don't even like it. But this one's so good. It's so soft and it's all natural, delicious shave ice. Absolutely recommend it. And it's also right near the Grand Hyatt or right near on the south side of Kauai. Recommend both those places. Very, very good. On Maui, I would try Ululani's Shave Ice. They also have some natural, like, not all the flavors are made, like, with natural colors and stuff, but a lot of them are. And that was also very, very tasty. Okay, that was very, very good. I'd recommend it. And they have that, like, all over the Maui. It's like a chain. And then for Oahu, I'd also recommend trying Hula Dog, which effectively is just Puka Dog. It's, like, the same thing. What happened, actually, is it was one chain, and then, like, the owners got divorced. And like, I think the husband owns Puka Dog on Kauai and the wife owns Hula Dog on Oahu. So it's basically the same thing. I prefer Puka Dog. I think it is actually a bit of a better taste, but both are good. I recommend trying either one of those. And so yeah, those would be the main food options I would recommend trying in Hawaii. So I really hope this presentation has been helpful to you. I hope I've been able to provide significant value. If you want to learn more about award travel and stuff like that, please consider joining the Travel Lane Discord group. Link in the description. Highly recommend it. Very, very smart people in there. And yeah, I really hope I've been able to provide significant value to you.